the course of cryptography and network security. So this course is for 4th BTech first sem. Myself G. Prashanthi, Department of Information Technology, Vignan Slara Institute of Technology and Science. So already in previous class we have seen the introduction of block cipher. So where block ciphers are used for providing the confidentiality. Okay, so where to provide that confidentiality, the sender will be encrypting the plain text into the ciphertext. Okay, so where the sender will be converting the plain text, or we can say readable message, into an unreadable form by using the encryption process. So that unreadable form will be sent to the receiver. So where the receiver will be decrypting that message. Okay, so where the receiver will be taking that unreadable message, he will be applying the decryption process and he will be converting that unreadable form into the readable form, and he will be knowing the information. Okay, so where this process is to provide confidentiality, where in confidentiality we will be hiding the data. Okay, while the message is being transmitted between the sender and the receiver, the message will be hidden by converting into the unreadable form. Okay, so that is about the block ciphers, where block ciphers will be encrypting one block of bits at a time. So that is why it is said to be a block cipher. A block cipher encrypts one block of data at a time. Okay. So, and similarly, we have seen some components of the block cipher. Where in the components of the block cipher, we have seen about the P-box, where the P-box is nothing but the permutation box that shuffles the bits. Okay, so whatever the bits that you are having in the block, the bits will be shuffled by using the P-box. Okay, or we can say those bits will be transposed. So, that is the P-box, where we have seen three types of P boxes, straight P box, compression P box, and the expansion P box. And then we have seen the S box, where S box is used for substitution. Okay, so here S box is used for substituting bits with some other bits. Okay, so if you are having any three bits, that three bits will be transformed with another three bits. Okay, so that is the S box, where it is used for substituting the bits. Okay, so where the input bits are substituted with the other bits. Okay, so that we have seen in P box and S box. S box may or may not be invertible. Okay, so there are some X boxes that are invertible and there are some S boxes that are not invertible. Okay, so here there are some S boxes that are invertible, and the number of input bits. Okay, so for the S boxes that are invertible, the number of input bits should be same as the number of output bits. Okay, so if any S box is invertible, so that invertible S box will be having same number of input bits and same number of output bits. Okay. So let's see one example for it. This is your invertible S box. Okay, so this is your normal S box, and this is your invertible S box. Okay, so this is the invertible S box. Okay, where we can invert to back. Okay, so here, for example, if the input of the left box is 001. Okay, so this is like this is the S box. Okay, so here invertible S box. So here if the input is like 001, so already we have said if it is like 001, so your the leftmost bits represents the column, and the rightmost bits, these two rightmost bits represents the this leftmost bit represents the row, while as these two rightmost bits represents the column. Okay, so there is the S box, where in the S box the first leftmost bit represents the row and the rightmost bit represents the column. So here we have to map, so 0 and 0 1, so here we will be getting the output as 101. Okay, so the output is 101. Okay, so for this output 101, if this is like invertible, okay, so you have to invert that. So here for inverting, so again we have to take, so the first as the row, so this is the row, and these two bits represents the column. Okay, so these two bits represents the column. So here we have to map. So this and this. Okay, so that's we have got the output as 001. So that is what our input is. Okay, so this is your input. So by using this invertible S boxes, we have again got back to your input. Okay, so this is used for encryption. If this is used for encryption purpose, then this invertible, this S box is used for decryption. Okay, so this box is used for encryption, whereas this box is used for the decryption. Okay, so that is about the invertible S boxes. So there are some S boxes that are invertible. Okay, for that invertible S boxes, whatever the number of inputs that you are giving, so that should be same to the number of outputs that you are getting. Okay, so this is one example of your invertible S boxes, where this S box is used for encryption and the next S box is used for the decryption purpose. Okay, so the next component, already we have seen some basic components of block cipher, like we have seen the P box, S box, and the third component of your modern block cipher is exclusive OR. Okay, so it is nothing but the XOR operation. So it is, this XOR operation is also called as the whitener. Okay, so sometimes in some technical terms it is said to be the exclusive OR, and sometimes it is said to be the whitener. Okay, so already you know the XOR operation, where in the encryption, so you will be taking like X. Okay, so you will be having some bits, like if you are having 000. Okay, so those will be XOR with the key bits. Okay, so XOR operation always takes with the key only. Okay, so here whatever the input bits that you are having, those input bits will be XOR with the key bits. So and then you will be getting your 1. Okay, so and similarly, and here whatever the input bits and the key bit should be same. Okay, the number of input bits and the number of key bits should be same. Okay, and then you will be doing the XOR operation between them, you will be getting the 1. Okay, and for the decryption process, what you have to do is that you have to take this Y. Okay, for decryption purpose, you have to take this Y, and again you have to do with the same key. Since it is a symmetric key block cipher, already we have said in previous class, so these are the symmetric key block ciphers, where for encryption and decryption we will be using the same key. So here also we will be using the same key, and you will be taking the output bits. Okay, those output bits will be XORed with the key, and you will be again getting the same input bits. Okay, so this is the encryption process and this is the decryption process. Okay, so where same key has to be used for both encryption and decryption. Okay, so that is about the one operation that we will be using in block cipher, exclusive OR operation. Okay, so next operation that is used in most block ciphers is circular shift operation. Already you know the circular shift operation, where you can shift the bits left, or if you want you can shift the bits to the right circularly. Okay, so if you move the bits circularly, you can't discard the bits. Okay, so if you do simple left operation, simple right operation, some bits will be discarded. Okay, so here we have to keep that 64 bits. If the bits are 64 bits, okay, if the input is 8 bits, the output should also be the 8 bits. Okay, so here we will be doing the shift left operation, circular shift left operation, where here we will be shifting these 3 bits. Okay, so these 3 bits are shifted to the left. Okay, so that then we will be getting as output after shifting the operation. Okay, so similarly shift right operation. Okay, so shift right operation, where the bits are shifted to the right side. Okay, so where the bits are shifted to the right. Okay, so after shifting we will be getting like this. Okay, so it is circular shift operations. Okay, so where if this is done for the encryption, and then this is done for the decryption. Okay, so if you are doing the encryption circular shift, if you are using circular shift in the encryption process, okay, so then during the decryption you have to do the right shift. Okay, so if you are doing right shift during the encryption, then you have to do the left shift in the decryption. Okay, so one is for encryption and other is for the decryption process. Okay, next one is your swap operation. Okay, so swap operation where you will be like dividing the bits into two blocks. Okay, so here 8 bits are divided into two halves. Okay, so like this is said to be the left part and this is said to be the right part. Okay, so next one is your swap operation, where in swap operation, so you will be dividing the blocks into two halves, that is n by 2. Okay, where n is the number of bits. Okay, so we will be dividing the bits into two parts. Okay, so the left part of 4 bits are called L and the right part of the 4 bits is called as the right bits. Okay, so this is the left bits, 4 bits, and this is the right 4 bits. Okay, so and then you will be shifting these 4 bits to the this way, and then you will be swapping these two blocks. Okay, so you will be swapping these two blocks. This entire block comes here and this entire block comes here. Okay, so for the decryption process, if you are using this for the encryption process, for the decryption process, again you have to swap. Okay, so whatever the elements that you are getting, so those will be swapped in the reverse order. Okay, so that is the decryption process. Okay, if it is used for encryption, so this is the encryption where you will be getting down arrows. For the decryption, you will be getting the up arrows. Okay, next thing we will be using, next component is split and combine. Okay, so here also we will be dividing into two parts. Okay, so whatever the number of bits you are having, so those are divided into two parts. Okay, so left part and right part. Okay, so this is what we are saying, like left part or right part. And then so combine, in the decryption process we will be combining those two parts. Okay, so that is the split and combine, where in the split it is divided into two equal halves, and in the combine those two equal halves will be combined. Okay, so that is the another component in block cipher. Okay, so those are the different components. Okay, those are the different components that we are having. Okay, so those are the some of the components that we have seen in the block cipher. Okay, so we have seen about the P boxes, where P boxes are used for permutations. Okay, permutations, or we can say transpose. If you are having one block of data like 0010, like that, if you are having like 64 bits, okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, if you are having like this is 63, this is the 64th bit. Okay, so if you are having like these bits, so a 64 bit block of data, then by using permutations you will be rearranging the bits. Okay, if you are having the P box, if you are having like straight P box, okay, if you are going with the straight P box, the 58th bit, okay, whatever the 58th bit that you are having, that will be becoming the first bit here. Okay, so if you are having like 8th bit, okay, so the 8th bit will be becoming the second bit here. Okay, so in that way we will be transposing the bits, we will be like shuffling the bits. Okay, so and your last 64th bit, the 64th bit will be the 7th bit, whatever the 7th bit that you are having, that will be becoming the 64th bit. Okay, so in that way we will be transposing the bits. Okay, so similarly we have seen the S boxes, where the X boxes, so the S boxes substitutes the bits. Okay, so if you are having 3 bits like 001, okay, so after going through the S box, okay, after going through the X box, so the output will be another number, 100. Okay, so in that way, so these this is substituted with these 3 bits. Okay, so in that way S box is used for substituting the element with another element. Okay, so where permutation transposes the bits, where S boxes substitutes one element with the other element. Okay, so and similarly we have seen your XOR operation. Okay, simple XOR operation where the input is XORed with the key. Okay, since it is a symmetric key, encryption and decryption uses the same key. Okay, so here the input is XORed with the key, then you will be getting the output Y bits. So for decryption, again those Y bits will be encrypted with the key to get the input bits X. Okay, and similarly we have seen like split and combine, where the bits will be divided into two equal parts, and then at the decryption side they will be combined. Okay, and then we have seen the swap operation, where in the swap also the input bits will be divided into two equal halves, and the left bits will be the right bits, and the right bits will be the left bits. Okay, in that way we will be swapping, where the left bits will be becoming the right bits, and the right bits will be becoming the left bits. That is nothing but the swapping. Okay, so those are the some of the components of the block cipher. So here now coming to the product ciphers. So product ciphers. So here Shannon introduced. So here the person Shannon introduced a product cipher. Okay, it is a type of encryption algorithm. Product cipher means that encryption algorithm. So and this product cipher is a complex cipher combining substitutions. Whatever we have studied here, whatever the S boxes. We have studied using those S boxes. They will be performing substitutions. So it consists of permutations, whereby using the P box, okay, permutations are done. Okay, that is transpositions are done, and other components discussed in previous sections. Other components discussed in previous sections means this XOR operation. Okay, whatever the XOR operation, split and combine, and then whatever the swap operation that we have seen. So by using all those components, this Shannon has introduced a product cipher, okay, that converts a plain text into a ciphertext. Okay, so there are some properties of this product cipher. So the properties of this product cipher is that the first term is that this product cipher produces the diffusion. Diffusion means that, so it hides the relation. Okay, diffusion means that by using those whatever P boxes and S boxes we are having, by using those P box. So here for providing this diffusion, we will be using the P box. Okay, the purpose of this P box, the purpose of using this P box is that it provides the characteristics of diffusion, or we can say it provides the property of diffusion, where diffusion is to hide the relation. It hides the relationship between the plain text and ciphertext. Okay, so that the attacker cannot know, so that the attacker cannot derive plain text from the ciphertext. Okay, since the ciphertext is being transmitted through the network. Okay, since the ciphertext is being transmitted through the network, the attacker can view that ciphertext. So here the attacker should not be able to derive plain text from that ciphertext. Okay, so so as to avoid the attacker from deriving the plain text from the ciphertext, what this diffusion, or we can say what this P box do, is that it hides the relationship between the plain text bits and the ciphertext bits. Okay, so here the diffusion, or we can say the P box, by doing that shuffling, okay, by doing the transpose, what is the why we are using this transpose? We are using this transposition shuffling so to hide the relationship between the ciphertext and the plain text. Okay, to hide the relationship between the ciphertext bits and the plain text bits. Okay, so that the attacker cannot derive the plain text by seeing the ciphertext. Okay, so similarly we are having another property called as the confusion. Okay, the idea of confusion is to hide the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. Okay, so here this confusion can be achieved by using the S boxes. Okay, so this property of confusion can be achieved by using the S boxes. These S boxes does what these S boxes do? These do the substitution. Okay, by doing this substitution, you can hide the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. Okay, so by using these S boxes, okay, so you can hide the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. So that the attacker, so by seeing the ciphertext, okay, by seeing the ciphertext, the attacker should not be able to derive the key. okay, since the ciphertext is passed through the network, okay, since the ciphertext is passed through the network, the attacker can interrupt and he can view the ciphertext. Okay, so here the attacker should not be able to derive the key from that ciphertext. Okay, so as to avoid the attacker from deriving the key from the ciphertext, so we are using the S boxes, and these S boxes hide the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. Okay, so these are the two important properties of the block ciphers: confusion and diffusion. Okay, so diffusion hides the relationship between the ciphertext and the plain text, and confusion hides the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. Okay, so to achieve this diffusion, okay, to hide the relationship between these two, so what we can do is that we can use the P boxes. And similarly, to hide the relationship between the ciphertext and the key, we will be using the S boxes. Okay, and similarly, the third thing we are having is the ROMs. Okay, so here diffusion and confusion can be achieved by using iterated product ciphers. Okay, iterated product ciphers means that we will be repeating that P box, S box, okay, so for some number of times, for 16 rounds, for 20 rounds, okay, so that is nothing but the iteration. Iteration means that we will be repeating those uses of S box and P box for some particular number of times. Okay, so where each iteration is a combination of S box, P box and other components. Okay, so S box, P box and other components means that other components in the sense XOR operation, swapping, combine. Okay, so we will be combining all these components into one, and then we will be iterating that into number of ROMs. Okay, so that is the third one, number of ROMs. Okay, so that a product cipher provides the diffusion and confusion property. For that, providing these, it will be using the S boxes and P boxes. And similarly, we will be repeating. So as to increase the security, okay, to enhance the security, we will be repeating that for a particular number of times. This is one product cipher made of two ROMs. Okay, so here, as you see, each ROM consists of all your components, like your P box, S box. Here, Whitener is nothing but the XOR operation. Okay, so here Whitener is XOR with the key. So, XORing with the key. Okay. So, here we can say this is the round one where you will be, it is taking 8-bit plain text. Okay. So, here it is taking 8-bit plain text. So, first what is happening is that the first these 8 bits are XORed with the key. Okay. So, since there are two ROMs, for each ROM we have to use different key. Okay. So, from the main key, so whatever we are having key K, so from this key K, we will be generating two keys, K1, K2. Okay, so we have to use some key generation algorithm. So here we have to use some key generation algorithm, or we can say round key generator. Okay, so this round key generator takes initial key. Okay, so this round key generator takes the key. From that key, it will be generating two keys, K1 and K2. Okay, K1 is used for round 1 and K2 is used for round 2. Okay, so here what happens is that first it takes these 8 bits, and this K1 also consists of 8 bits. Okay, so this K1 is also of 8 bits. So here this plain text is XORed with the K1. Okay, so after doing the XOR operation, again we will be getting the 8 bits. Okay, so those 8 bits will be going through the S boxes. Here we are using 4 S boxes, okay, where those 8 bits will be divided into 2 bits, okay. So first 2 bits will be going to S box 1, next 2 bits will be going to S box 2, and the next 2 bits will be going to S box 3, and the last 2 bits will be going to the S box 4, okay. So next is your P box, okay. So where P box does the transposition. Okay, or we can say it shuffles the bits. Okay, whatever the 8 bits that you are getting from the S box, those will be permuted by using the P box. Okay, so by using the P boxes, those 8 bits will be permuted, and then we will be again getting the 8-bit middle text. Okay, So again we will be getting the 8 middle legs. So up to now we have completed your round 1. Okay. So again round 2 will be going. So where in the round 2 we will be again having the same operations. Okay. So that but here the XOR will be done with the key K2. Okay. So it is the second round. So this is the second round where the 8-bit middle text, whatever the middle 8 bits we are having. So those 8 bits are again XORed with the key K2. Okay. So these 8 bits are XORed with the key K2. Widener means that XOR operation. Okay. So XORed with the key K2. And then again you will be getting the 8 bits. So those 8 bits will be going to the 4 S boxes. So again you will be getting 8 bits. Okay. So those 8 bits will be again goes to the P box, where in the P box those bits will be transposed. Okay. So again you will be getting the output, and those output will be your final ciphertext. Okay. So here whatever the S box, that S box produces the confusion property. Okay. So confusion means that it hides the relationship between the ciphertext and key, and the P box produces the diffusion property. That means that it hides the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. Okay. And you will be having a key generator also. So this key generator takes the key as the input, and it generates two subkeys. Okay. K1 and K2, each of 8 bits. Okay. K1 is of 8 bits and K2 is also of 8 bits. Since the plain text is 8 bits, those keys will also be of 8 bits. Okay. So that is a simple product cipher that is made of two rounds. Product cipher that uses the basic components. Basic components like your XOR operation, S box, P box. Okay. By using those operations, we will be encrypting a plain text into a cipher text. Okay. So that is a simple product cipher made of two rounds. Okay. So here we are having two classes of product cipher. Okay, so two classes of product ciphers called as the feastal ciphers and non-feastal ciphers. Okay, so feastal ciphers are a basic building block for all the modern block ciphers. Okay, if you go through even modern block ciphers like your Blowfish, IDEA, or if you say DES, AES, all those block ciphers are built on the basis of these feastal ciphers only. Okay. So, feastal ciphers. So, here the modern block ciphers are divided into two classes, feastal cipher and non-feastal ciphers. So, first let's see the feastal cipher. Okay. So, this is the feastal ciphers. Okay. So, feastal cipher is a very intelligent and interesting cipher that has been used for decades. Okay. So, till now also whatever the new ciphers, modern ciphers that you are getting, all those modern ciphers are also based on these feastal cipher only. Okay. So here the first thought in feastal cipher design is that, so whatever the plain text, okay, plain text, it is an n-bit block of plain text. Okay. So the plain text will be XORed. So here this is an XOR operation, and the key goes to a function f. Okay. So this function f consists of some S boxes, it consists P box. Okay, so whatever your product cipher you have seen, it may contain some swapping. Okay, so it may contain some combinations, whatever the building blocks you have seen. Okay, so that is contained in function f. Okay, the function f consists of these S boxes and P boxes. Okay, so and XOR operation also. Okay, so the whatever the block component, what are the basic components you have seen. So some of those basic components will be included in this function f. Okay. So the key goes to the function f, and then the output of that function f is XORed with the plain text. Okay. So then you will be getting the ciphertext. This is the simple encryption process. And if you go for the decryption, you have to take the ciphertext. Okay. So you have to take the ciphertext and you have to take the key. Okay. So you have to take the key. Again, whatever the function that you have used in encryption process, same function has to be used in the decryption process also. Okay. So using the same function and using the same keys. Okay. So whatever the output that you are getting, so that will be XORed with the ciphertext, and then you will be getting the plain text. Okay. So this is the first thought in the feastal cipher design. Okay, so and then they have made some improvements. Okay, so and then they have made some improvement in the feastal design. So here what they have done is that they have like split it. They have used it like they have used it like split and combine. Or we can say split and combine. Okay. Or so here what the plain text. The plain text bits are divided into two halves. Okay. So the plain text bits are divided into two halves, left bits and right bits. Okay. If the plain text is of 64 bits, if the plain text is of 64 bits, then the left bits will be 32 bits and the right bits will be of 32 bits. Okay. So here it will be divided into two halves and then you will be taking the right bits. Okay. So here the right bits and the key will be going to the function f. Okay. Where again in function f you will be using some s boxes and p boxes and you will be using some XOR operations. Okay. So function f consists of p boxes, s boxes, XOR operation. Okay. So and those operations are done on the right bits and the key k. Okay. So after doing that operation we will be getting the output. So that output is again XORed with the left bits. Okay. So the output is again XORed with the output bits. Then we will be getting the left bits and your right bits will be same. Okay. So the right bits will be same as it is. Okay. So here when coming to the left bits, so what you will be doing is that right bits and the key goes to the function f. Where you will be using some S boxes and P boxes and XOR operations, and after that the output will be XOR with the left bits. That will be your left bits. Okay. So similarly, decryption is the inverse of this process. Okay. So decryption is the inverse of this encryption process, where you will be going from downwards. So again, same process. Again, you will be taking the right bits and the key. Again, it goes to the function f. So where this function and this function should be same. Whatever the S boxes that you are using, either those S boxes has to be used or either the invertible S boxes has to be used. Okay. So here the function F consists of S boxes and P boxes and some XOR operation. So same as this function. Okay. So same function. And then whatever the output you are getting from this function, that will be XORed with the left bits. So again, you will be getting the right bits and the right bits will be same. Okay, so that is the decryption process and this can be done for number of rounds. Okay, if the number of rounds is 10, so this process is done for 10 times. This function is done for the 10 times. Okay, so this is the feastal cipher with two rounds. Okay, so same function, see here. So see here again the plain text is divided into two halves. Okay. The plain text is divided into two halves, left half and right half. Okay. So again, as seen in the previous slide, so whatever the right bits and the key we are having, that goes to the function f. Okay. And then the output of this function f is XORed with the left bits. Then you will be getting the left bit and right bits. And then here we are doing like swapping. Okay. So here swapping operation is done. Here split operation is done. Okay. And in the function f, you will be using some S boxes, P boxes and some XOR operation. Okay. So and XOR operation. And then after swapping, again, you will be getting left bits and right bits. So whatever the function, same process is repeated here again. Okay. So same again, right bits goes to the function f and the left bits XOR. So again, you will be doing a swapping operation. Okay. So again, there is a swap operation. Okay. So when coming to the decryption, okay, so this is your ciphertext. So after combining this left bits and right bits, okay, so again you are combining here, okay. So since you have splitted here, you are combining here, okay. So after combining, whatever the text you are getting, that is said to be the ciphertext, okay. So at the decryption side, again that will be splitted, okay. So again split operation. So again, the ciphertext is splitted. So again, it goes to the swap operation. Okay, the left bits and right bits will be swapped. Again, it goes to the function f and XOR operation. Okay, this is round one. So again we go for the round 2, okay, and then again here comes the combine operation. Okay, so here we will be doing the combine operation and here we will be doing the swap operation. So the decryption is the reverse of this encryption process. Okay, we will be doing the reverse operation on the we will be doing the reverse operation for decryption. Okay, so here the keys, so whatever the keys that we are using, so here the sub keys will be generated. Okay, already we have said in product cipher, so we will be having a key generation algorithm. So from that key generation algorithm, since we are having two rounds, we will be generating two sub keys. Okay, so here K1 is the sub key that has been generated for round 1 and K2 is the sub key that has been generated for the round 2. Okay, so by using those sub keys, we will be using the encryption. So similarly for decryption also, we have to use the same keys. Okay, so for decryption process also, we have to use the same keys. Okay? So that is about the freestyle cipher with two rounds. So, and in this only we are also having non-freestyle ciphers, okay, where non-freestyle ciphers uses only invertible components. Okay, so it uses invertible components in the sense that, so for S-box, we will be having an invertible S-box. Okay, so S-boxes, already we have seen an invertible S-boxes, and even if we are having straight P-box, but straight P-box also is an invertible. But the compression and expansions are not invertible, okay, because in compression we are discarding some bits and in expansion we are like increasing the number of bits. Those are not invertible, whereas straight P box is an invertible and S box is also invertible. So we can use those invertible S boxes, invertible straight P boxes, so by encryption and decryption. Okay, if you are using those invertible components, then it is said to be the non-freestyle ciphers. Okay, so non-freestyle ciphers uses the invertible component. A component in the encryption cipher has the corresponding components in the decryption cipher. Okay, so if you are using the S-box here, you have to use the invertible S-box in the decryption. Okay, so that is about the non-freestyle cipher where you will be using the invertible component.